由 KTSF 26台及东华医院联合制作的《聚焦东华》，由东华医院特约赞助播出。
欢迎大家收看聚焦东华，今天我们会继续和大家走访下东华医院的各个部门，以及和他们的员工聊聊天，继续深入认识东华医院。
联合国儿童基金会指出，因为空气污染，每年导致儿童死亡的数字已经超过了疟疾和艾滋病的总和。联合国儿童基金会最近发布的一个题为 Clean the Air for Children 的报告当中指出，每年有超过60万5岁以下儿童因为空气污染导致死亡，这一现象在贫困国家尤为严重。报告要求各国领导人采取四项应对措施，包括减少使用煤炭能源和加大节能科技的研发，提升儿童医疗保障水平，避免儿童暴露在污染的空气当中，提高对大气污染的监测。根据世界卫生组织的数据，全球有超过20亿儿童生活在大气污染水平高于世卫标准的地方，而且大部分是在发展中国家。
今天我来到东华医院的最底层，他们的 B2 地牢下面的第二层，就是他们的放射部，而在我身边的就是他们的部门主管 Dr. Ng Roger。 Thanks for giving us the tour of your department. So what are you going to show us today?
Well, we'll give you a little sample of all the main areas that we do imaging here in our department. And
sure.
We can take a little tour here of some of those areas today.
Cool, cool. So where are we going now?
Well, let's start with one of our newest pieces of equipment, the MRI machine. We'll walk over there right now.
Sure, let's go.咁頭先咧 ，Doctor Ng 咧就話帶我哋嚟睇磁力共振房先噶。咁而家我哋咧就喺身處喺磁力共振呢一個地方啦。So, Doctor Ng, can you briefly tell us, what's MRI?
Well, MRI is the ability to look inside the body without using radiation. Mm-hmm. It's brand new to here in Chinatown. For the first time ever, we have that service here. And I'd like to introduce you to one of our MRI technologists, Tony, who will explain a little bit more about what's going on here at MRI.
Sure.
Hi, hello. Good morning. Tony, welcome to MRI Scan Room.
Okay.
歡迎你到磁力共振室的掃描室。
多謝你，多謝你。咁頭先咧 ，Doctor Ng 就講咗咧，就係磁力共振咧喺我哋嘅社區咧係一上次非常之新嘅科技啦。之同時咧，磁力共振咧係冇任何嘅輻射嘅。咁啊 ，Tony 可唔可以同我哋講講更詳細 MRI 係啲咩咧？
磁力共振咧係一個係好先進嘅、好新嘅一個醫學影像嘅手段啦。咁樣咧就佢係可以不但只係睇到人體嘅骨啦、組織啦、軟組織啦，仲有係神經系統啦、血管系統啦，所以係非常好嘅一個醫學嘅一個影像嘅一個工具。
通常咩病人會嚟用 MRI 多咧？
通常都是一個是腦部啦，腦部腫瘤病人啦，或者是有脊椎啊、頸椎啊問題啊、腰椎問題啊，同埋係一啲比如係重要嘅器官方面嘅問題啦，比如係腎臟啦、肝臟嘅問題啦，咁啊亦都會係做到四肢嘅一啲疾病方面嘅。亦都可以嚟到係進行掃描嘅。
唔該曬你啊，唔
該曬，好。
由於時間關係，我哋喺下次嘅節目時間先至繼續同大家參觀放射部嘅其他設施，千祈唔好錯過。
大家都知道吸烟有害健康，但全美每日依然有4210万人加入咗烟民嘅行列。为帮助烟民戒除烟瘾，科学家对此进行咗大量嘅研究。而家就提供几个有效嘅方法，帮大家戒除烟瘾。首先，可以俾自己一啲戒烟方面嘅财政激励，例如加入一啲戒烟财政激励计划。 和其他参与者一起共同努力成功戒烟，有机会获得现金的奖励，相信会令你更有动力戒烟。另一个可以做的就是寻求帮助，研究显示只有 4% 到 7% 的人群可以在没有任何帮助的情况下戒除烟瘾，所以当你烟瘾发作的时候，最好寻求家人朋友的帮助，例如和他们聊聊天、散散步来分散一下注意力。
现在坐在我身边就是东华医院放射科的部门总监 Dr. Roger Ng。Roger 原来是第五代的华裔移民，他现在在东华医院里面做什么，他的家庭背景又是怎样呢？现在立刻跟他聊聊。 Hi Roger, thanks for coming to our program.
Thank you Kevin for being here.
Yeah, so I know you're the fifth generation of an immigration family. Can you tell us more about your family history and most importantly about yourself?
Well, as you said, my family first immigrated to America many, many years ago, actually predates the American Civil War. They came over on 6 junks across the Pacific and landed in Monterey and became farmers there for a generation or two before moving up to San Francisco.
Okay.原來 Roger 屋企咧就喺好耐好耐之前已經嚟到啦。咁當其時咧就仲喺 Civil War 之前嘅，即係內戰之前啦。咁啊，當其時嚟到咧就喺呢一個 Monterey 啦。咁啊就做農夫，後來咧就嚟到三藩市噶啦。Talking about yourself, what did you study in college?
I studied genetics.Which is the field of looking at DNA inside each cell, which has helped me well in understanding medicine when I then went on to do my medical studies.
So how come you become a radiologist?
Well, when I was going through med school, as I was going through all my clinical training, I kept seeing, regardless of whichever specialty we were training in, surgery, medicine,and so forth, that when the major diagnoses were being made, it was always using imaging to be able to find out what was wrong with that patient.
原來呢Dr. Ng 最初在大學的時候就是讀這個遺傳學的，認識 DNA 啊那些這樣，直至到去到醫學院之後呢，他就選擇了這個叫做放射科。因為其實放射科在任何的治療裏面，甚至乎在一個手術裏面，其實是擔當著一個非常重要的角色的。 So Dr. Ng, how many years have you been working in Chinese hospital?
I've been at Chinese hospital for 14 years.
14 years. So why are you still continuing working in Chinese hospital? Why you choose hospital actually?
Out of all the locations and hospitals I've worked at, there's been no greater satisfaction in terms of the difference that I feel I can make as a physician than at Chinese Hospital. And also too, it's sort of part of my family's upbringing. By my father and my grandfather, who were very active in the community, they impressed on us that we should give back to the community. And when the calling came by a lot of my mentors to return back to Chinese Hospital and help serve the community, that was an easy choice to be there. And it's been a great experience ever since.
Dr. Ng 在 Chinese Hospital 已經做了有成14年了，那為什麼他會選擇東華醫院，也為什麼會繼續留在那裡做呢？就原來就他受到家人的影響，家人原來在這個社區，我們環社區也是非常活躍，兼且也是來自東華醫院的，他覺得就說回歸社會是一個非常重要的一個責任，而且他們在這裡東華醫院裡面做，他對自己能夠服務到環社區是非常大的滿足感的。So I know your family is also working in Chinese hospital. They are also doctors. So will that influence you to choose a medical study in college?
It definitely had reinforced my interest in becoming a physician. Mm-hmm. But crazy enough, I was interested in becoming a doctor when I was in third grade. Wow. Like much like others want to become a fireman or a policeman, I just never grew out of it andpursued that dream to where I am today.
Why when you were so young you want to become a doctor?
Again, it comes back to that philosophy of trying to give back to the community, and I think there's no better way to do that than to help others in need and who are in need of becoming healthy again.
咁作為一個醫學世家嚟講咧，對於爸爸啊，或者係屋企人啊、親戚啊，都喺醫院裏邊工作咧，對於 Dr. Ng 咧係有一個某程度上嘅影響。但其實原來佢自己個人嚟講咧，佢好細個喺三年級嘅時候咧，已經係好希望咧就係做醫生噶啦。咁點解有呢一個夢想咧？原來都最主要都係回饋社會呢一個原動力，令佢咧就選擇呢個醫生作為佢嘅終身職業嘅。由於節目時間關係，我們今天跟 Dr. Ng 談到這裡，在下次節目時間我們再繼續跟 Dr. Ng 深情對話。
你好，我是梁優依文，以下我們會解釋一下什麼叫做飽和脂肪 Saturated Fat 和反式脂肪 Trans Fat。 飽和脂肪在室溫會形成固體，反式脂肪是由輕化過程而形成，它將植物油由液體轉變為固體。這兩種脂肪都會增加血液中的壞膽固醇，所以對心血管是不利。飽和脂肪可以來自於植物或者動物，來自於動物包括牛油、豬油、雞油、全脂奶類製品以及肉類的皮和脂肪，來自於植物包括椰油、椰奶、棕榈油。反式脂肪的來源包括酥皮餅食、快餐店的油炸食品、零食、通常用來製作點心的餅食植物油，以及條狀的人造牛油。如果你想攞多啲呢方面的資料，請瀏覽華人社區健康資源中心的雙語網站 www.cchrchealth.org。
透過今天的節目咧，對東華醫院又加深了認識啦。今天的聚焦東華時間亦都到呢一度結束，再會。
由 KTSF 二十六台及東華醫院聯合製作的聚焦東華，由東華醫院特約贊助播出。